Thomas was waiting at a junction when a bus arrived. Hello, said Thomas. Who are you? I'm Bertie. Who are you? I'm Thomas. I run this branch line. So you're Thomas, eh? I remember now. You got stuck in the snow. I took your passengers and Terence the tractor pulled you out. I've come to help you with your passengers today. Help me, said Thomas. I can go faster than you. You can't, said Bertie. I can, huffed Thomas. I'll race you, said Bertie. The drivers agreed to the race going ahead. The station master said, are you ready? Go. Thomas never could go fast at first, and Bertie drew in front. Why don't you go fast? Why don't you go fast? Called Annie and Claribel. Wait and see, wait and see, hissed Thomas. He's a long way ahead, they wailed. But Thomas didn't mind. He'd remembered the level crossing. There was Bates, while they sailed gaily through. Goodbye, Bertie, called Thomas. After that, the road left the railway, so they couldn't see Bertie. Then they had to stop at the station to let off passengers. Pip, quickly, please,
wait,
called
I'm
Thomas.
Gordy.
And off they went again. Come along, sang Thomas. We're coming along, sang Annie and Clarabel. Hurry, 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 panted Thomas. Then he looked ahead. There was Bertie tooting triumphantly on his horn. Oh, dearie me, groaned Thomas. Steady, Thomas, said his driver. We'll beat Bertie yet. We'll be Bertie yet, we'll be Bertie yet, echoed Annie and Clarabel. We'll do it, panted Thomas. Oh, father, there's a station. Then he heard Bertie. Goodbye, Thomas, you must be tired. Sorry, I can't stop, we buses have to work, you know. Goodbye. Oh, dear, thought Thomas, we've lost. But he felt better after a drink. The signal dropped. Hurrah, we're off! Hurrah, we're off, puffed Thomas. As they crossed the bridge, they heard an impatient honk, honk. There was Bertie waiting at the traffic lights. He started with a roar and chased on after Thomas again. Now Thomas reached his full speed. Bertie tried hard, but Thomas was too fast. Whistling triumphantly, he plunged into the tunnel, leaving Bertie toiling far behind. I've done it, panted Thomas. We've done it, hooray, we've done it, hooray, chanted Annie and Clarabel as they whooshed into the last station. Everyone was there to celebrate Thomas's victory, but they gave Bertie a big welcome too. Well done, Thomas, said Bertie, that was fun. But to beat you over that hill, I should have to grow wings and be an aeroplane. They now keep each other very busy. They often talk about their being bounced like peas in a frying pan. And the Fat Controller has warned Thomas not to race at dangerous speeds. So although, between you and me, they would like to have another race, I don't think they ever will. Do you? Thank you.